We were going to give Regis an eye test, and this was the pointer from the eye test, and I forgot I had it, and now I can't put it down.
No, that was the guy, you better behave yourself, stick.
You better behave yourself, that's right. Hey, on Monday's show, Helen Mirren, of course, from the new movie Red, will be here. And we've got a big, big, big announcement that you're not going to want to miss coming up at the end of Monday's show, and Regis returns, and so make sure you tune in because it's very big.
Wait, he's come back? This isn't like...
Oh, did they tell you this was a permanent thing?
Just for the day.
All right. Oh. I'm sorry, guys. Don't worry.
No, it's all right. Go back. I've got that pretzel cart thing I did as a kid.
Don't worry.
You can break back into that.
No, it's
That's
fine.
Hot
you'll
with the hat and
you'll
the
be fine. You can only host so many shows.
That's true.
Don't worry. Okay, so she's a multi-award winning actress with a diverse career in television, stage, film. Please welcome the gorgeous Mary Louise Parker. Second time on our show.
I know.
And Regis has not been here both times. And I have to ask you, what did you do to upset him so much?
I think it's too much for him. Our chemistry is too painful.
Palpable.
Yeah.
We have a connection.
I can feel it right now. Yeah. I mean, I'm sitting here right now.
Yeah, it's too much for him to handle.
Yeah, no doubt.
Mm-hmm. You have to understand it. I mean, this is, you're talking to a power player here. I mean, she's done just about everything. So, look, I mean, sixth season of...
Weeds.
You know.
Oh, yeah. We love Weeds.
I didn't bring that up.
Nice. And
your show is big in our house.
Which one?
By the way. The diners, drive-ins, and
Seriously, don't stop. Seriously. come with that. Don't even. Just go on.
We
can talk
appreciate
all day about
that
it.
Kind of food in
you
my family.
He hosts really compelling shows, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Triple D. Is it? And have you been to any of the Triple D's before?
Well, yeah, my dad was really a fan of the SOS. That I'm probably not supposed to
stuff
spell
on
it
shingle.
Out.
Stuff
on a shingle, right?
Yeah.
Right.
PC. They had it in the military, and he really, really liked it.
So you like diner food? Do your kids?
I
are your
do.
Kids adventurous? Because I know you have a little boy and a little girl.
Yeah, my daughter would eat that flour, but my son, no. Like, I made him salmon the other night, and I had to scrape off every little thing that wasn't pink.
Yeah. Like, right.
But he's the performer of the family.
Yeah.
Okay, because I have the two boys, and one's a performer and one's not.
Ah.
But he's a performer, and your daughter's kind of behind the scenes. She'll do a cameo in his
upcoming
film.
Yeah, well, put on a show the other night, and it was The Life of Buddha.
Oh,
and
my gosh.
Will had to be Buddha. I know.
It's very
sounds
deep.
Pretentious.
It's very deep.
No, usually
Winnie the Pooh at my house. I mean,
usually it's more like Scooby-Doo influence, but Scooby doesn't appear in Buddha. So, my daughter just wanted a cameo. Yeah.
Do they ever make you like be the class parent? Like you have to teach the theater segment, or is there a lot of expectation for you when it comes time to do the class play, to make the costumes, or?
Not yet, but you know, I bake things, and
that's my territory.
Oh,
I'm not, you know, I'm not showing the kids how to
drive. I made brownies, actually.
I bet the parents get excited when you make brownies.
Well, I did make brownies.
That's it.
I did, and I turned to one of the mothers and I said, there's something green in the but I meant spinach. You
yeah,
know?
Sure
and
you
did. And
her
face just kind of fell, and she's horrified. I saw her whispering to me. I was like...
Yeah, that's what I call it, spinach. Yeah, that's exactly.
We've got. Well, of course, we're only making jokes at the character you play on Weeds, of course, which is by the way, I think everybody's favorite show. It really is terrific, and you're
fantastic.
Sixth
season, right?
Yeah,
and you participate. I mean, there's a lot of crazy storylines that go along with this, but you're not shocked by them because, from what I know, you are involved in creating this wild tale.
Yeah. So, well, some of the things that happen on the show, I think maybe might be happening this Monday, in fact, are sometimes they're my idea, but then I can just, you know, if my mother is watching or something, I saw they made me do that. Maybe you shouldn't watch because...
We have to take a commercial break. We're going to talk about Red when we return.
Still ahead on Live, Emma Roberts.
Oh, no.
This is the Divine Mary Louise. Candace Parker, of course, who plays Sarah, who is the love interest of this retired CIA agent, Bruce Willis, in the movie Red.
Mr. Willis,
which stands for Retired Extremely Dangerous.
Yeah.
Right. Which, by the way, in the world of movies, these are right up my alley.
Yeah,
okay?
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. This is the 80s rock 'em, sock 'em, knock 'em out, blow it up. I mean, the trailer, all I want to watch is just the trailer over and over
again.
I
saw the trailer.
Yeah, it's great, right?
I haven't seen the movie. But...
Oh, it's rocking. You haven't seen the movie yet?
No.
Let me tell you about it. So what you get
what happened?
So have you ever worked with Bruce Willis before?
No, I hadn't met him or worked with him.
Because we always think like everybody in movies in Hollywood all knows each other. That's the rumor.
It's like XM radio where you're walking down the hall. Hey, what's up, man? How you doing?
Some people in Hollywood. Yeah. Think that too.
Yeah.
They see somebody else on a TV show and they'll go like this. Yeah. And I'm like, I haven't met you, but.
Right.
No, they think about that in Food Network. They think that, like, you know, I have an office right next to Mario and Emeril, and then Bobby's across the hall.
Don't.
You know, hey, what's up? No, it's.
That's not true. That's very upsetting.
It still is for us, though.
Okay.
Let's talk about this prank, because I'm a big prankster.
I know you
are. I'm a big prankster. My crew on Triple D, since you're a Triple D fan, my prank that they did on me is we were at this one restaurant, and the chef was a little bit shorter, and they put him in the cooler. And so we're in the middle of the scene, and we're cooking along, and the guy I'm cooking with says, hey, can you grab me the cream out of the cooler? And I open up, and this little guy goes, here you go. I hit the ceiling. So I'm into a good prank, and your prank is along those lines. What'd you do to Bruce Willis?
Well, Bruce, you know, he's quite well known, obviously, and he said one day this woman saw him, and it was as though she'd been electrocuted. She was staring at him. And he said he feels like sometimes, he was completely gracious to her, but he said he felt like sometimes people like respond to him as though they've just seen an alligator fly out of a swamp and start singing Chuck Berry, and like, so. I one day, a couple days later, managed to find an alligator and put it in his trailer, and I put Chuck Berry on, and I had John Malkovich tell him that we were gonna have lunch in his trailer, and I hid in his shower, and he came in and he opened the cooler, and there was the alligator. I mean, truthfully, it was more like a kind of bloated lizard, it was like this big.
Do you just pack alligator typically with you?
No.
I have an alligator, you want to do anything with this?
This is when you see, when you're a movie star, you're like, listen.
Can I have an alligator?
In my writer, it clearly states I need an alligator.
No, that's a crocodile.
And I know the difference of those. Let's take a look at this clip. Now, in this clip, you're waking up after being kidnapped by Frank Moses.
You're going to love this movie when
Bruce
you
Willis.
Do see it.
I'll get you the clip.
Take a look at Red.
Where are we? How did we get to New York City?
Wow, I really hate you right now.
Just hoping you'd be a little more understanding of the situation.
I was hoping not to get kidnapped or drugged. I was hoping you'd have hair. So it looks like none of our dreams are coming true at the moment.
Sorry about that.
Thanks for saving me, I guess.
No problem.
Not my best first date. Not my worst, either.
Also from the movie Red, Academy Award winner Helen Mirren.